As you may know, I am a big fan of Nickelodeon. I loved SpongeBob as a kid. It's sad to hear that Steven Hillenburg passed away. I was actually crying when I found out he died. He was my childhood. So in honor of him, I bought every SpongeBob DVD from season 1 to season 10. I also found a guy in front of the street who was selling a lost SpongeBob episode DVD. I told him, "How much?" He said it costed $1. I bought it and turned on my DVD player. I was curious about the DVD, so I popped it in. The first thing I saw was the Nickelodeon fish floating around. I was really back in memory lane. But then I noticed something. The fish's eyes were bloodshot and the fish itself was red. Well, I didn't really care about it, so I kept watching. The menu screen was just a stretched out PNG of SpongeBob with a title called SpongeLost.mp4. I clicked on it. The first thing I saw was the intro. I was glad to see my childhood. Until the title card came up. The background was just dark and there was a pentagram on the back of the wall. The title of the episode was called Lies. I had a mysterious feeling about the episode. During the title card, a creepy backwards music box was playing. The first thing that showed up was SpongeBob eating some kelpo next to Gary. It looked like a normal episode so far.
"Well, Gary, I am heading to work. See you later, Gary."
After SpongeBob left the house and off to work, he saw a fish hanging from a tree and it zoomed in on its detailed face. There was blood coming out of his eyes and his skin was decomposing with flies all around him. I was really scared at this point. SpongeBob screamed and ran as fast as he could to the Krusty Krab. When he walked in, there were people who were waiting in line for Krabby Patties. Then I heard Mr. Krabs yell out,
"SpongeBob!"
The only thing off was that it wasn't the original voice actor. It was a man who sounded like he had a cold and was 65 years old.
"These customers are on a frenzy here. You must make those Krabby Patties immediately."
SpongeBob ran into the kitchen without saying a word. He started making Krabby Patties. Then it was just a loop, like the Flintstones, of him flipping Krabby Patties. And this is where the whole episode just goes downhill. As the loop of SpongeBob flipping patties kept on going, a metal door shaking could be heard out of nowhere. Later on, screams of innocence could be heard. It sounded like a torture room. I started to shake. Then, SpongeBob started melting, until his rib cage started showing. The room got more darker and the screams started to get louder. The whole kitchen was set on fire. And eventually, the audio stopped. SpongeBob stared at the viewer. He said,
"People think I am a good person. Lies, lies, lies."
Then everything came back to normal. He called Mr. Krabs. When he came, he was confused. SpongeBob already knew how to make Krabby Patties. But then, the most craziest thing happened. SpongeBob grabbed Mr. Krabs' head and smacked it onto the stove that was already heated. He kept smashing his head into the stove until the only things that were left was blood and pieces of Mr. Krabs' head. SpongeBob started laughing with blood all over his face. He went to Squidward. Squidward told him to bug off. SpongeBob said in a demonic voice,
"You will face the wrath of SpongeBob. Prepare to die."
He grabbed Squidward's chest and ripped it open. He ripped out his heart and soon enough, Squidward fell onto the floor. Dead. While SpongeBob was looking at the beating heart, it showed a close-up of the heart and it wasn't your normal cartoon heart, it was a real heart that looked photorealistic. I didn't have a bucket with me, so instead, I threw up on the floor. As I kept watching, SpongeBob entered the gym. He saw Larry and gave him a protein milkshake. As Larry drank it, he started throwing up blood, but it wasn't your normal cartoon blood. It was either Mountain Dew Code Red or real. As he fell on the floor, he was completely white and a pool of blood was right next to him. SpongeBob was laughing evilly, as he showed the viewer he had put some cyanide pills inside of the milkshake. Next, he went to Sandy's tree home. Sandy was working on a brand new invention that looked like a feller buncher. SpongeBob then picked up a rock and threw it into the glass. The tree dome cracked a little until it broke. Sandy then died because of the rock that SpongeBob threw at her window, and when SpongeBob saw her floating dead body, he then said,
"I just need one more kill."
Then it cut to SpongeBob circling Patrick's house with a bat full of nails. Patrick was scared and was biting his fingernails, even though he didn't have any nails or fingers. SpongeBob opened the rock. Patrick screamed. Then it cut to a pitch black screen that said, "Inatanadatsu Genoda. I used Google Translate on my phone. It meant, you are next." Then the scene cut to SpongeBob's house. Then, it showed the inside of the house, which was all dirty and trashed. There was also a pentagram on the wall, and it was the same thing in the title card. The next room had Gary in it, dead with his shell broken and ice looked. The next room showed a bunch of dead bodies of the fish kids. SpongeBob was lying in bed with a knife in one hand and a sad face covered in blood. He said,
"Why, Bikini Bottom? Why?"
He sighed and said,
"I guess this might be the only way out."
SpongeBob slipped his wrist and wrote lies on it. He died shortly. Then the episode ended. I ended up having nausea and suicidal thoughts. But luckily, I found a therapist to help me out. I still like SpongeBob, but I will never look at him the same ever again.